Alright guys, it's Christmas and I'm out walking and I thought it'd be quiet. It's not, there's loads of cars on the road, so hopefully you guys can hear me. So Christmas is a funny old time, you know, some people love it, some people hate it. I think irrespective of if they're estranged or not, but you know, it doesn't take a therapist to know that when we are estranged from family members, Christmas is going to be particularly painful. And I've noticed this with my clients particularly, especially in the build-up to Christmas. Even on Christmas Day, they become very withdrawn. Physically, they start to feel very depressed, very sad, very apathetic. Some just want to crawl into a ball and just hide in the bed for the day. And I understand that. And to be quite honest with you, I was a bit like that myself for a few years. I mean, I used to love Christmas myself, pre-estrangement. After the estrangement, it was quite difficult for a few years right after that. And it's just loss, and the reality of loss. It takes its toll, and it's going to be really emphasised around this time of year. So, look guys, I know it may be hard for you. I hope you're doing okay. I hope you have people around you who are cheering you up a little bit, or even trying to cheer you up. It may not be possible to cheer you up, but I hope you have people around you anyway. And it's important to be around people who are happy, and you do enjoy this time of year, because you know, happiness can be contagious sometimes. People rub off each other, and you may find that, you know, just being around people are happy, you may enjoy yourself a little bit, you may forget the situation a little bit. But I would ask you just to use Christmas Day just as a benchmark, just to check in with how you're feeling in relation to how you felt last Christmas, and also reflect on how you might want to feel next Christmas. And what, but then you need to decide how you're going to get yourself today. You have to aim yourself in that direction. So it's deciding that 2020 will be a time of change. You're going to maybe start doing some work on yourself. Some people decide to go to therapy, some people decide to take on a fitness program, change the nutrition. These are all good things, they're all positives, but they have to be sustainable. You have to do it over the course of the year, and maybe the goal for next year is being in a slightly better place next Christmas. This is an interesting Christmas for me because it's the last one where I'm not a parent. We're due our child, a little son, in a couple of weeks, only about 2 to 3 weeks. So next year is going to be very different for me. I don't know how it's going to be. I'm very excited about it. I'm looking forward to being a father and having the little person in our lives and enjoying Christmas with them. But just a quick message, guys. I hope you're all doing really well. I appreciate the support just of the channel, of the group, and all the different people who've emailed me, and I hope I've been able to help a small bit. And I'm going to be here in the new year, and if anybody wants to reach out, please shoot me an email, and I always try to get back to people as quickly as I can. So have a good Christmas as best as you can. Have a good new year. You know, own the new year, embrace it, even if you're really painful, even if you don't feel like it, embrace it as best you can and try and make something of it and reclaim it, just for your own sense of autonomy and not letting the family situation completely dominate your life. So that's it guys, have a good time and mind yourselves, and I'll see you all the next year. Take care, bye bye.